Welcome to Learn and Understand FreeMarker. My name is Parsifal Coletta and I'm going to be your trainer on this course. I'm an IT solution architect focused on healthcare and I'm passionate about learning new technology and teaching. FreeMarker represents a powerful engine to generate text output, like web pages, email, and general reports able to support management. And it's truly something that can simplify and boost your work. I don't believe that you can learn by imitating other people's code. The problem is that, in the real world, you can find scenarios completely different from those addressed in a course or a book. What you really need is to understand. Understand what tools are doing for you. Understand how things actually work. So in this course, you are going to understand some fundamental template engine principles that are necessary to understand how FreeMarker works. We'll talk about how FreeMarker works and does the things it does, and we'll then be able to understand the examples that we look at in the way that you'll be able to apply what you have learned. So that's it. Welcome to the course. It's time to get started. FreeMarker and other template engines like it have come into being to solve some problems. Knowing what problems FreeMarker is trying to solve will help you to understand how it works and how it accomplishes solving them. Alright, so let's look at some example code. On my desktop, I have already started fake SMTP that is listening on port 2525 of my localhost. In this panel, we will see the emails that will be sent by our application. So I open up Eclipse and we are going to look at a quick example. In the project Explorer, we have the planning reminder project. This project is very important for us because will be our case study for the rest of the course. It's organized in two packages, model and services. The model package provides the user and the relative plannings. The user has an email, some demographic information, and a list of plannings to remind. The planning has the name of the course and the relative date start and date end. In the services package, we have the sub-package email that provides the business logic to send an email. The send method of the email service accepts an email DTO that brings together all the necessary information to send an email. That is the sender and receiver information, the subject of the email, and the relative message. The implementation of the email service uses the Apache email library to send an email. And the information about the SMTP server host and server port are read by the configuration file application.properties that for this project are set to localhost as SMTP host and 2525 as SMTP port that are the same used to run fake SMTP. In the end, we have the planning service interface and the relative implementation. The interface defines a send planning method that accepts a user as arguments and has the aim to build to the given user a reminder email with his plannings. The implementation of the send planning method creates an email DTO to bring together all the necessary information to send the email, and then calls the send method of the email service that we have seen before. The message is created by the getMessage method that accepts the user as arguments and creates an HTML message based on the user information. Here we have the planning reminder message header. Then we can see a hello message with the full name of the user, and at the end the user plannings in a table presentation. In this class we have also a main method to run the code. We are gonna call the send planning method of the planning service with the Petzili user. Petzili has three planning about FreeMarker, Java Enterprise and Angular. To run the main method, we simply click on this play button. The code is now running, and at the end we can see that fake SMTP shows to us the message generated for the Petzili user. Clicking this row, we can see the generated message. As you can see, the code is very simple and accomplishes the work. But we have a big problem. The problem is that we have coded in the business logic how the data will be presented to the final user. And each time we have to do a change, for example, we want to change the color of the text, or we want to change the presentation of the planning, and so on, we have to update the code and then patch all customer application. Wouldn't it be awesome if we could modify the appearance of the document without patching the entire application? That's the basic idea that's behind the various template engines that, like FreeMarker, have become popular. Template engines were designed to allow the separation of the business logic, that could be, for example, retrieving data from a database or calculating shipping costs, from the presentation of this data. So this is one of the big problems that FreeMarker is solving along with some others. So let's get into how these problems are going to be solved and what are some of the basic concepts that FreeMarker uses to solve them.